So let's take a look at some of the important settings that you should pay attention to when you set up a Google class. So go ahead and open up, go to classroom.google.com and open up your class. And then up here, you'll see the little gear in the upper right. Click on that to get to your settings. So in here, you can give, you can change your class name. You can add a section, for example, what period it is, room, what subject. And here's your class code. You'll notice that you can display this, or you can reset it or disable it so other students can't get their friends and family to add into the classroom, or you can reset it and just give the new code to anybody new who enters your class. You can also take a look at how you want your class stream to show. Do you want to show attachments in detail for each one? Or do you want them condensed so that you basically just see the title, and to see any details, a student would have to click on there? And you can also hide notifications if kids are just going back and forth, commenting on things that you don't want them to. You can also show your deleted items. Only the teacher would see these. They'd be kind of grayed out, and sometimes that's handy if you've deleted something, but you can see if you want to get it back. This is very important, the grade calculation. Right now, there's no overall grade and the students can't see anything to do with grades. So we're going to come up here and we're going to say total points. Notice you can also weight it by category. I'm going to say total points and I'm going to turn that on so that the students can see their grades. And here, if you are doing weighted, you can add grade categories, especially if you're going to weight your gradebook. When you're finished setting up your settings, make sure that you click save or nothing will take hold. One further really important thing underneath the settings is under stream. Are you going to allow students to post and comment? If you do, I'll warn you that there'll be all kinds of silly comments on your stream. So I would say that students can only comment. They can always comment on their assignments, ask you questions, and comment on your questions or announcements that you have on your stream. But I think that's really important. Otherwise, you kind of have chaos in here if students can post things as well as comment. And don't forget that if there are some students making inappropriate comments and things that underneath people, you can mute a particular student underneath actions. You can mute them.